Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn something very good. If you're using Kali Linux, if you're using Ubuntu, if you're using another Unix systems, any Unix system, you might facing the same challenge, and maybe you don't know what to do, but here we come with a great solution. Here what you're gonna do, what I was trying to do is I downloaded my database from an online servers, then I wanted to copy it to www directory. You're gonna see that in var. So but what is happening here, I can't do that. Reason being, I'm gonna explain the reason. Let me go to downloads. I got this, I wanna copy this, and also I can't paste, I can't create a folder there, so it simply means it's something like a disaster to me. So what you do, you go to VA, then AR, then you come to here, and then you go to HTML here. Then I want to create a folder, then I put my stuff, I can't, this is disabled, I come here, it's disabled, I come here, it's disabled. I can't paste in here even if I use Control V to paste. Even if I try to anything, anyway, it can't happen here. So simply means this thing is like disabled. What can I do to fix that? So it's not disabled, it's like if you're not root, if you're not sudo, it's difficult to do that unless if you give yourself those privileges to do so. So now you can see all these are disabled, only that which is working. So now to know where we're gonna go, we're gonna go in here, we open. Okay, did you see that? To do a shortcut, instead of typing that, you just say open in terminal, or open terminal here, you say that. After that, what you do, you can see all this address, you copy this address the way it is, because this is the directory where you want to copy or paste or do whatever you want to do. You copy that section, then it says cd. After cd, then you say sudo, sorry about that, then you say su, then you say enter. After that, it's gonna ask you for your password. Put in your password, root password. And then you say enter. After, when you see this hashtag, just know that you're good to go. So what are you gonna do? I'm gonna say chmod, then say space minus capital R space, then 777. Here what we're doing, so we wanna give the directory the read, write, and execute powers, or what they call rights. So once we give that those rights, then after that, so we're giving the rights here, then we're gonna say who are we giving the rights to, then we paste here, we say we're giving the rights to /var/www/html, and then that we're gonna give rights. So whichever or whatever folder which is gonna be in those folders, or in the that folder where it ends, you see on HTML, in if I'm gonna create a folder inside the HTML, or what is going to happen, I'm going to be allowed to create a folder there, I'm going to be allowed to delete a folder there, I'm going to be allowed to create a file there, I'm going to be allowed to paste a file there. So which means I'm going to copy my DB, I put it there, I'm going to create my programs and put them there, maybe PHP programs, whatever you want to use that for, they're going to be allowed to be in there. So now what's next? What's next, you just click say enter. You can say enter. Once you see there's no error, no what, just know that that has worked as a charm. So now you're gonna do this. My battery here in the mouse seems like it's getting tired. You click back here. We can go back and click here and go to we're gonna go file system. Then when you're there, you're gonna go to var. When you're there, then you look for that folder www. When you're there, then you click on HTML. Then once you right click, you can see you have now powers. You can see these ones were, you can rewind the video anyway to be sure. These were, these options were like what we call, they were disabled. So we can create a folder, we can create a document. So now I'm going to create a folder here and I'm going to call it D. So why I call it D, I don't know. I just call it D and say okay. So in that D, I can open that D. Still, I'm going to have this power to create a folder in here. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back and copy this. I say copy and I go to that file system. Okay. When you're in the file system, then you can go and var. Then in the var folder, you look for the folder called the www or www. Click there. And then if you in there, then you click for, look for HTML. And when in there, then still you look for the whatever folder you created there, then you can say paste. Once we paste here, we can take even this thing. We say rename. We can rename it to any name we want. I can name it to my DB after rights. Okay. Then after we say rename, when I rename, the file is super good. I can right click also. I can delete this. Say move to trash, cut this. You can do whatever, but before you could not. Why? There were no permissions for you. So let's go back here and look into this this folder. We can't see anything. Simply means like something's hidden. Okay, if we here, you can see these are hidden. Why? Never, because we never gave this folder what? In this folder, we didn't give it permission. So if you have any other folder you want to have permission for, log into sudo, run the commands I gave you. But anyway, some people use those commands, you do the same thing in a different way. But anyway, if you log in as sudo, like maybe your account is a root pass or root what account, you might not need that, this, and it won't give you this issue. So then you are now you know how to do that and what is the cause and how to fix it. So that's the reason why we did say that it's maybe necessary for us to create this tutorial to teach the little we know about these powers or permissions on Kali Linux. So a lot of people would like to understand and to know why these are disabled. The reason is Kali Linux is so sensitive if it comes to security. So they want to be sure that whoever access some specific part of the operating system must have full rights to do that. We have to know him. So that's why you can find, like on this account, I can't install any software before it asks me for the password, login as sudo, whatever. They pass through some steps so that they protect you from any attacks or any mistakes, like somebody just deleted something, a very important file, someone comes and play on the computer and delete some stuff. So the good thing about these Unix systems is like even if they limit error making, or they limit human mistakes, you get me? So like I deleted a file, I didn't know, I'm sorry, you know, all those things. So there's places where you cannot delete a file unless if you put in a password, or unless if you log in as who, or unless if you give the permission to that specific area that this person can delete a file, this person can do this, this person can do this. That's the thing I'm trying to say, that is something which I'm telling you now. So now you can see, even if we go in here and some folders, maybe some files are hidden, I go to Apache here, I click in here, I don't see anything here. So there is a reason why. And if you go here, you can find some things, but you cannot delete them, you cannot touch them until when you get those rights to do so. So now you know how to create a folder, to delete a folder, to do what, to copy and paste in the So I think that is a very good thing if you're new in Kali Linux or in Unix systems. It's not only Kali Linux, also other Kali Linux, other Linux flavors, they do that, especially if you're not sudo. So if you want to make yourself sudo, also that is possible, whereby you're not going to be asked all those things. But it's better you leave it that way, because it's going to protect you anyway. Guys, I hope this is a good tutorial for you, and I hope it helped you. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.